Welcome back. I hope you've been identifying all your negative habits and doing everything you can to cut them out. Remember, these negative habits are killing your future. So yeah, hopefully you're starting to pick out the negative habits and replace them with better positive habits that will eventually improve the quality of your life and help you get to success a bit quicker. But in today's lesson, as I said in the last lesson, I said I'll talk about routine in today's lesson as it follows on quite well. So by having a well-established routine, it actually helps build habits. So it's a very good lesson to follow on. Now, a lot of people think about routines and think they have a routine, but have never actually written it down and taken time to think about what they're doing on a daily basis. Similar to habits, a lot of it is subconscious. So we need to be aware of our routine and where we're putting our time each day. So by having a well-established routine, it's going to help with being more productive and being time efficient. It's going to give you a faster route to your goals. It will relieve stress and anxiety, improve your health and well-being, help you build these new habits. It gives you that dedicated time that everyone needs for personal growth and personal development. Now, by having a routine, you can plan and schedule all these activities, which is going to benefit you massively. So everyone's day routine changes quite a lot with just depending on what they're doing on a day-to-day basis. It's not always going to be the same thing and the same routine. But what could be the same thing, and it's most likely to be repeated on a more frequent basis, is your night routine and your morning routine. Now, there's a lot about morning routines, and everyone wants to know about morning routines, but it all starts the night before. The night routine is so important because that is actually what is going to set you up for that morning routine. Make you have a plan in place to execute your morning routine. So to start with, I suggest really focusing on your night routine and then building your morning routine after that. You can sort of shift it and add in more things to your day-to-day life once you've achieved this night routine, a morning routine. Then you can start implementing new things and new habits as such into your routine. For example, I said it improves your health and well-being. This is because if you have a routine of going to the gym, it's going to improve your health and well-being. But it's about having a routine. It's not about making an option. It's about routine. It just becomes part of your day. It's not an option. It's just part of your day. Once you start to look at it this way, then you'll find less excuses for it because you just accept that you've got to do it. It's part of your day. And that's just how it is. So let's start with planning out your night routine. Now, a must for the night routine is no screens or phones or TV or anything like that. At least at the bare minimum, half an hour, but an hour if you can. Now, everyone goes to sleep at a different time, but that doesn't change anything. You can just turn your phone off, put it on airplane mode, make sure you've got your alarm set for the morning. Don't watch TV, get in the zone, be like, yeah, my night routine starts at this time, and this is when I take all these actions. Now, your night routine doesn't have to be anything too complicated. It can be really simple, but if you stick to it, it can have a major power. So, for example, my night routine revolves around my training a little bit. So, I get home from training at about 8:30 usually, and I have a really small meal, just protein based, that's going to help with muscle recovery. Then, I'm on my night routine. Latest I start my night routine is 9 o'clock. I plan to be asleep just before 10. So, my night routine actually starts at 9. Starts with brushing my teeth, doing what I've got to do, and then I have a stretch out, I'll meditate, and then I'm in bed, I'm journaling, I'm ready to journal. And I spoke about what to journal about in the journaling video, so you have a good understanding about that. But I'm planning my day for tomorrow. I'm talking about how today went, like, have I achieved what I set out to achieve? And if not, then how can I do it tomorrow? And then I'm adding new things that I want to achieve tomorrow and making a plan. Now, in my journal, I will show you, I've got my night routine and my morning routine, like, just written out. So, as of today, my morning routine and my night routine. So, night routine, like I said, starts at 9. Wash my face. Yeah, do what I've got to do. So then I'll stretch out, I'll meditate, and then, like I said, the journaling. Then I'll read my book about boxing, as you know. to then go to sleep, and I'm asleep by about 10 o'clock. So that whole night routine takes about an hour. And yours should too. And that's no screens and just really focus on the night routine. So you've got your night routine, you smash through it, and you can stick to it. Then we talk about the morning. What time do you wake up? What do you do first thing? And what that first sort of hour in your morning is your morning routine. Everything's usually done just by habits, and you're not really thinking about what you're doing. You're just doing things just because you do them. But if you can actually make a plan and set out to achieve things and say you're going to do things in the morning, then you do them, then you're going to have such an advantage over everyone. So my morning routine consists of waking up at 6. I find this is a good time to wake up to make sure I can get everything done, and it gives me enough sleep as well. I wake up at 6, I have a glass of water straight away. You've got to be drinking your water straight away. Dehydrated after eight hours of sleep, so you need to be rehydrating as fast as possible. Grab my water, I have my clothes set out the night before. I get up, and as I'm injured right now and I can't run, I go for a walk. If you can't run, you can walk. If you can't walk, you can crawl. You can always do something. But I like getting out in the fresh air, and it's a nice morning in the sun. So out there, I'm out the house about 10 past 6 and on a nice walk. It can be from 10 to 20, but it's usually about 10, 15 minutes. Just nothing excessive. It's not exercise. It's just a walk to wake myself up and clear my head. When I get back from my walk, I have a stretch out. This is usually about 10 to 15 minutes as well. I've got a stretch every morning. That's just what I find beneficial to me, as I'm aching from the day before, or I'm going to be taking part in a lot of physical activity that day. So I have a 10-15 minute stretch out every morning. Then I go into my meditations. This can last, if I'm rushing or if I've got time, depending on what the day holds. Then sometimes I even fit in a 3 minute, or it can extend to 20 minutes if I've got the time. But usually I meditate for about 10 minutes in the morning. After my meditation, I work on my affirmations. I've got it up on my wall, which I will show you after this video. Shouting to myself, waking up the neighbours. I am, blah, 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 blah. Getting pumped up, ready for the day. I'm also visualising at the same time of where I want to go, what my future looks like. I've got pictures of my idols and of myself. Visualising of where I want to go as well as performing these affirmations. Now, after I've completed this, I then go downstairs and I've got my journal out. And just before I eat, I make sure I journal. I make sure I've ticked off everything that I need to do. And I'm looking at my list of goals that I want to achieve today. I'm thinking, how can I achieve them? And I'm adding more on, because I always think of something more that I need to do that day that is going to benefit me. So I add more goals and to-do lists and stuff like that. Reminders, even, like anything that comes to you, just write it down in the morning, make sure you have a plan in place to execute. I then reward myself, like I talked about in the habit video, with my breakfast. So that is my morning routine. It takes about an hour usually. Obviously, it can vary to like shorter, longer, depending on what the day holds, like I said. But as long as you're sticking to something and you're doing it most days, then you're going to be ahead of so many people and you're going to see the benefits from it. So that's my night routine and my morning routine. So I perform these on a regular basis, daily basis, and I try and stay really, really disciplined and completing the tasks that I set out to do. I let people around me know, because it's difficult if you don't actually let people around you know your night routine, because a lot of people like to stay up late or talk to you or stay on the phone or something like that. So just let them know. Just be like, look, I'm working on this night routine and I can't look at my phone. So yeah, simple as that. You know, you've got to look after yourself. Nothing else matters. You've got to look after yourself. And this is gonna improve you. Like I said at the start of the video, it's gonna improve your growth. It's gonna give you time for that personal development, that personal growth. This is that time. Night routine, morning routine, where you're going to grow the most. Now, if you can stick discipline to these morning and night routines, you'll be ahead of 99% of people. You'll be on that track to success so much faster. You'll be achieving so much more on a daily basis. You'll be so much more time efficient. Get so much more done. You won't believe it. All by just having a morning and night routine and performing these actions. So it is so important. But remember, look after yourself. That's number one. You've got to look after yourself. It doesn't matter what your friend's doing. It doesn't matter what he's doing, she's doing, whoever's doing. If they're staying up late saying it's great, cool. Let them do that. Let them do that. We look after ourselves and we work on ourselves every day. So if you can stay disciplined to this morning and night routine, then you'll see the benefits. Trust me. So, task for today, you've got to write your night routine first and your morning routine. It will change and you will adjust to different things. And you might think like, ah, I don't like that, or I like this, I'll do more of this. Or you might wake up one day and feel really good, might wake up the other day feel bad, and you just see like what you're enjoying, what you're not. So, write a night routine, a brief night routine and a brief morning routine that you're going to stick to every day, and just try your best, like commit to excellence, commit to it 100%, and see how it goes. So here you can see I've got some affirmations. I've got my idol Vasily Lomachenko with the belts. There's myself as a young kid punching a bag. You become what you teach. Verb and affirm your desired outcome. Visualize and clearly see the outcome you desire. Walk, talk, and act like you're the person I want to be. All growth requires you to move out of your comfort zone. So that's my main board. Then we've got my whiteboard, success, happiness, and achievement. My purpose is always bigger than my excuse. Blah, 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 blah. Big Muhammad Ali. These are my affirmations. Read out almost every morning. If you want a list of them, then just let me know and I'll give you them. But yeah, keep working on that morning and night routine and get ahead of 99% of people. Keep it up, champs.